Hey guys, today I want to talk a little bit about printing area, how to set up the printer and the slicer, and avoid some common mistakes in the process. Normally, when people create their new printer and the slicer, they tend to check the manufacturer's specs for the print area dimensions or measure the print pad and type in those values. Although this often works, it's not accurate, and here's why. When you define your printer in your slicer, you are defining your X, Y, and Z printable volume, and that volume is determined by how much your nozzle can move over your print pad. There are some cases where this area is a bit bigger and you can stretch your printing size a few extra millimeters, but in some other cases, the size might be smaller, either because the way some X's are assembled or because the end stop's installed position. But first, we must start with the home position. The home position is your absolute zero coordinate for every axis. This is the starting point, and it's defined by your end stops or your mechanical limits if you have drivers with the sensorless function enabled. The standard, except for Delta printers, is to have the home position on your bottom, left, and front corner. And most slicers have that indication. So, with that in mind, we need to set up the printer so that the zero coordinate matches the corner of the print pad. There are some cases where the end stops are far out from the corner of the print pad. In those cases, you need to know the distance from the nozzle when at the home position to the edge of the print pad and define an offset. This way, the machine will know that when the printer completes the home sequence, the nozzle is actually at a specific distance from the bed, and when it reaches the edge of the bed, the coordinates will be zero at that point. If you don't define this offset, your printer will assume the end stop position as being the zero coordinate, and the printer coordinates will not match with the coordinates of the slicer. The center of the printing area and the slicer will not match the center of the printing bed, and you will also have the risk of printing outside the bed. For the cases where the print bed is bigger than what the axis can move, that spot will be your starting point. And it's one example where you cannot use the bed size as the value to be used for your printer definition in your slicer. If your printer allows you to move the end stops freely, install them at least a few millimeters away from the print edge and define that distance as offset. This way, you have a safety clearance that you can use during the home sequence and also avoid hitting the end stops every time you print close to the edge. And to do that, start with your Z and adjust your Z end stop if your printer does not have an auto level sensor. Level the bed using a 0.1 mm thick piece of paper. Next, home all the axes. Using the menus on the display, move your X and Y axis until you get the nozzle on the corner of the print bed. Make sure your Z is still at the zero coordinate and then select Set Home Offsets. It's important to only apply home offsets for the X and Y axis, never for the Z. Next, execute home all axes again. Now, you will see a negative value on the screen for the X and Y axis. These are the offsets. If you move the axis again to the corner of the print pad, you will get the 0x0 coordinates. Don't forget to store these new values into the EEPROM. Now that we have defined the zero and the starting point of all the axes, we need to check the total travel for each axis and confirm how far they can move over the print bed. To do that, after homing the printer, we go to the printer's menu and for each axis, we move them until they reach the edge of the print bed. Or, for the cases where the bed is bigger than the axis length, we move until just before they reach their mechanical limit. The total distance is indicated on the display. And this is the value that you need to enter in your slicer for the print setup. The total travel must be checked for the Z as well. But for the Z, there is something extra you need to take into account. You need to remember that when the print is finished, the slicers normally raise this axis a bit more at the end of the print to prevent collisions between the nozzle and the finished print. You need to consider this extra movement when checking and defining the max print height to avoid the Z hitting the upper mechanical limit. If your slicer is defined with these limits, you will be aware of these limitations before starting your print and avoid crashes. So guys, with this procedure, your slicer's printing area and coordinates will always match your printer's, and you will know exactly where the prints will be made on the bed. For the cases where the bed is bigger than the axis length, you will be able to define your correct bed area, and you will prevent having your axis hitting the far side of the home positions or printing outside of the bed limits. That's it, you guys. I hope you liked this video. As always, don't forget to hit like. If you want to follow me here, click on the subscribe button. And also, check my Facebook page for more extra 3D printing stuff. If you like my work and wish to help, you can with Patreon. I'll see you guys next time. Bye!